In this webcast, we're going to discuss different acid-base properties of heterocyclic systems. In this example on this slide, we're going to compare the two conjugate acids of structurally similar molecules. On the left here, we have the conjugate acid of pyridine with a pKa of 5.2, and on the right, we have the conjugate acid of pyridine with a pKa of 11.1. Now notice the large degree and difference in acidity, and remember that the lower the pKa, the stronger the acid. So we know that the conjugate acid of pyridine is the stronger acid of the two. If we look at this table that relates hybridization and acidity, we can explain the difference between the pKa's between these two conjugate acids. If we recall for the carbon series, that as the percent S character in an orbital increases, so does the anion stability. And we can explain this because the more S character in an orbital, the closer it is to the nucleus. Therefore, a negative charge would be stabilized by the positively charged nucleus. So if we use the same line of thinking and look down the nitrogen series, we see that that positive charge wants to be as far away from the nucleus as possible, and it can do that in an sp3 hybrid orbital over an sp2 and sp hybrid orbitals. So therefore, if we go back and look at the two structures again that we dealt with a second ago, pyridine is an sp2 hybrid nitrogen, and pyridine is an sp3. So using the rules in the table, we see that the sp3 hybridized nitrogen should be a more stable cation than the sp2 hybridized nitrogen. Thus, if it's a more stable cation, it's a less reactive species. Therefore, we can see why the pyridine is the much stronger acid and more reactive. And if we recall again that S character, because it's close to the nucleus, stabilizes negative charge, and also because it's close to the nucleus, it destabilizes positive charge. If we look at this table of substituted pyridine derivatives, we can see the large effect that substituents have on the lone pair of the nitrogen and pyridine. We recall that the lone pair in nitrogen for this two connected nitrogen is in an sp2 hybrid orbital and is not tied up in the pi system. It's perpendicular and sticking out of the side of the ring and not in conjugation with the pi system. Therefore, it's free to be a base or a nucleophile, whatever the conditions may be. So if we think of adding electron donating groups onto this ring, we can think that if we add an electron donating group, either through inductive or resonance effects, we can increase the electron density or increase the reactivity of this lone pair through the electron donating effect from the different groups. And the table shows that different electron donating groups do in fact make the nitrogen lone pair a stronger base. And analogously, if we think about attaching electron withdrawing groups to the pyridine, we can think that electron withdrawing groups inductively pull electron density all the way through the ring away from the nitrogen, making the lone pair less reactive as a base. And in fact, the table shows that also. We can just think of it pulling electron density all the way through the ring and having less electron density at that nitrogen lone pair. Now if we consider this case, where we have the conjugate acids of pyridine and pyrrole shown on the left and right, we see a very large difference in acidity between the two conjugate acids. And what we should also note is the conjugate acid of pyrrole is very acidic with a negative 3.8 pKa. So how can we explain the difference in acidity between these two structures? Well, if we recall in the neutral species, the lone pair in pyridine is in the sp2 hybrid orbital and is not part of the pi system. So if that lone pair is used as a base and gets protonated, it doesn't disrupt the aromaticity of the molecule. If we look at the pyrrole system here, and we look at the neutral species, if we were to use the lone pair here on the nitrogen and get protonated, although that's not the structure shown here, if we were to protonate this nitrogen right here, that would pull those electrons away from the pi system. And we recall from the pyrrole that we learned earlier, the three connected nitrogen, the lone pair is in a p orbital, and it does contribute to the pi system. So if it was protonated, that would no longer contribute to the pi system, and the molecule would no longer be aromatic. Now note that in the case of the conjugate acid, it's not the, in the structure shown here, it's not the nitrogen that gets protonated, but the carbon adjacent to the nitrogen. Now how can we justify that? We saw that the different resonance contributors to pyrrole had passed a negative charge around the four carbons in the ring and had nitrogen with a positive charge. We saw that there was a negative charge shared by all the carbons in the ring. Therefore, the carbons are more basic than the nitrogen and are less, thus more likely to be protonated. So again, for the case on the left for the pyridine species, after protonation, the conjugate acid is still aromatic. And for the pyrrole conjugate acid, it has lost aromaticity in its conjugate acid because it no longer has a cyclic array of p orbitals to form for the aromaticity. And again, pyrrole is protonated on the carbon because the resonance contributors show that the carbon atoms all bear a partial negative charge and are thus more basic than the nitrogen.